Cancer, how are you? So, Cancer, I am doing your July 2021 reading and happy solar return, Cancer. Happy birthday. We've got Cancer sun, moon, or rising. So, Cancer, it's your first house. The energies are about you. How you are navigating your way. The energies will definitely be changing as well for you. You have a lot of energies that are surrounding, well, it's obviously, taking care of the home, family, also yourself. But you also have, Jupiter that is going to be trining you, even though Jupiter is, retrograde still, it's still going to be helping you. You have Uranus, which is sextiling you, so there can be lots of life-changing energies that are going to be happening, whether it's to do with like your home, career, yourself, your image. This is going to be very, it can be quite shocking to you, but it's going to be life-changing. You are also gonna it's also going to help you in order to move forward in anything you actually want to do. You have the new moon that's going to be in your first house, so this is a great time to be setting new intentions when it is concerning energies and feelings concerning, what you want to do in life, and let's not forget we have Mars, which is in Leo, your next door neighbor, so that could also shift things in a very crazy way, but it will also help you as well. You obviously your energy is very different to Leo, but still, that energy, that fire energy is going to actually help you when it comes to like accumulating money and accumulating like resources and your talents. So, even like the first week for you, Leo, Cancer. I don't know why I said Aries and Leo. For the first week for a lot of you Cancers, you're easing your way into your sign. You're easing your way into your actually feeling what is actually going on with the world around you. And if some of you Cancers are not feeling like secure, it could be physically, mentally, emotionally, or even financially. Things are going to start to move in your corner, and it obviously is because of, obviously it's because of, like what the planets are saying, but still, emotionally, I feel that a lot of you are feeling the shift, because even the first week we have the five of Pentacles, and the five of Pentacles, you can see there's this person or this man that is, obviously very financially secure, and it's feeding people, it's giving money to people who are, it's giving money to people who are not really, financially secure, basically. You could say that they're beggars. It could even be, it looks like beggars, but actually it could, if you are like a boss of a company or even like a small company, Cancers, you could actually be feeling very generous yourself, because even your self-worth is going to be very boosted for the first week. So you could be, you could be giving your boss, you can be giving your employees a pay rise, or you yourself can receive a pay rise. But the first week it does feel very generous, but it's more comfort, generous in comfort, and things are actually finally moving in your way. Yes, you have Saturn, which is in your eighth house, but that is definitely transforming you when it comes to like your deep re your relationships. Excuse me, but it's also transforming your finances. So if you've worked really hard, you've had lots of lessons from Saturn being in Capricorn, but now you are, I feel that the first week you could start receiving some type of like benefits. And even if it isn't financial, it could be from people. It could also be from new groups, organizations. It could also be from money that you've had, that you've earned or you've worked very hard for in the past, and it's now coming back. And this could actually be quite a shock as well, especially you've got Uranus there, and the card you have is Indigo card. And the message from Indigo is, you know, the person or inquiry about an indigo, meaning a highly sensitive natural born leader. So you yourself could be an indigo. Indigo is to do with empathy, is also to do with, you know, being very different when it comes to feeling out surroundings as well. So, you know, you could start feeling more of that indigo color come in. You know, I feel that there is more, you know, you feel there's more actually coming. There's four more that you actually need to learn about, you know, yourself, people around you. Also, it could be finances as well. Your second week is more, you know, I wouldn't say it's very serious, but I feel that your second week, it's like the second like decan of Cancer. So it can feel very quite heavy, you know. You could feel like more of, you know, because in the second week is also the new moon, which is in your sign. So the energies are changing now. You know, you could actually start feeling that the energies of the new moon happening. So you may want to be getting more serious, or you may want to be getting more structured in what you want to do. Because you know, you have the Hierophant card, which is about structure. It's also to do with, you know, not necessarily hierarchy, but it is, you know, doing the right thing, doing things that you're that doing things the right way. But also it's a spiritual card, so the second week is about connecting to yourself more spiritually in what you would like to get into your life, what also you would like to, you know, new beginnings. This is about new beginnings. So you may, you know, the second week is about working towards like your future goals, in where you want to go until we have the full moon, which is in your sign in December. Okay, so you know, if it is something that you have always wanted to do, now's the time to do it, you know. But the Hierophant card is showing you that, you know, because the Taurus card, you know, in Cancers and Tauruses get on very well, but also you may start doing something new, but also doing it from what you did in the past as well. Okay, so you know, that's about going back to basics basically. So you know, you have ascending masters, and the spiritual card for this is powerful, loving and wise spiritual teachers are watching over and guiding you. So you are protected. You are, you know, to be, you know, this card is showing you're protected. And it's also helping to guide you into the right direction. Sometimes there's nothing wrong, Cancers, in you doing something new, but doing it in an old school way, because that's the way that you actually feel comfortable. So second week is about comfort, but it will feel quite life changing, because you know, I feel that there is an element of seriousness to your new goals, but also working to the tune that actually suits you. The third week is very much a, you know, getting on with what you're doing, you know. So this could also be tending to like the family, you know, the home, but also wanting to, you know, be around people that you feel comfortable in. You know, you have the Temperance card, and the Temperance card is an angel, and it's the Temperance card is it's a moderation card. It's a Sagittarius card. It's a Jupiter card. It's a powerful, but it's also very positive. But then it's also saying that you could do too much. So you could be trying to do too much this week, Cancer, you know, trying to put all your eggs in one basket, but then, you know, you just tire yourself out. So you have to be very careful that you're not rushing. And also, sorry, speaking of rushing, but you know, you're not rushing, but you're also not, you know, you're rushing, but you don't get anything done. You know, really concentrate on the things that are more, not serious, but concentrate on the things that need your attention first, before you know, pursue another course of action. So, you know, if you know that you have to, I don't know, work out, for instance, you don't leave it to the end, you know. Or if you do, you that you want to work out, then you want to, you know, write, then you want to, you know, clean the house and take your time, because the third week I feel that you are going, they feel like there's some energy of a bit of rushing. But you know, you're going to your own timetable, and it could actually make you just very exhausted, which can make you more, you know, internalize your feelings. You may not want to speak your truth, you know, or even like when it comes to like your partnerships as well, really say that, you know, you need help. Don't try and do everything yourself. The fourth week, you know, we are coming into that, there's the Leo season, which is in your second house. So this is about money. This is about your self-worth and your income. You know, there's quite some, not explosive, but there's quite some like drama that's happening. You know, we have, you know, Venus, which is opposing Jupiter. You know, we also have, you know, which is a good thing. We have the full moon actually in Aquarius that is in your eighth house. So you could, because you're ruled by the moon, there could be some, you could feel like some quite explosive energies. The full moon is about releasing. So I don't think you'll find it hard. Well, it does depend on what Cancer you are. So it may be hard to release, but you may feel it's more of a relief to release. You know, you have like the Queen of Pentacles, and it's a lovely figure of a lady who is looking at the Pentacles card. I feel like, you know, even though it is a money card, I do feel that it is a week, the last week of, you know, your sign, that it's very much an emotional time, because I do feel it is because of the full moon that's happening in your eighth house. And the eighth house is a very emotional, deep, dark house. It's a very transformating house as well. So you could actually feel it very, not only easy or not easy, but still, you know, waters run very deep, should I say. So, you know, there does feel like a sense of comfort that's going on, but still, you know, there's things deep inside that's actually stirring within you. And you may not want to actually talk about it. So this is a great time to actually write about it, Cancer. Write about your feelings. Write about, you know, if you are doing any setting intentions for what you would like, or what you would like, actually what you would like to release. It may be best for you to write it down, because, you know, not everyone will actually understand what you're actually feeling and going through. Okay, and so yeah, so you know, you could be thinking about the past a lot. There could be elements and thoughts about the past, and you know, it could be about money, but it also could be about a relationship. You know, with the eighth house being in it's a deep house, but it's also to do with like sexual relationship as well. So if, you know, your mind could just go back there. Okay, and the eighth house is to do with like debts and resources. So there could be some worry that is coming towards when it comes to like, you know, if you've got debts to pay off or people owe you money, these thoughts can all come up. Or if they have been cleared, you know, your mind could just go back there. So try and keep, you know, this is a great time to do some self-care towards the end of July, because, you know, it's ending your sign. And I feel that, you know, you've learned a lot. But, you know, you may be going back to the past a lot about what you've learned as well. So you have listened to your intuition feelings. So your body is receiving accurate messages from the divine. So it ends pretty, yes, it feels very sad the last week of July, because you are going back over the past. But also, you know, listen to your feelings as well. Listen to your gut feelings. It won't let you down. But also, you know, this card, I feel, is also saying, you know, try to remain positive as much as you can, because what happened in July, you know, this is just a general, but there could be more deeper things that will actually happen to you in July, whether it's to do with the planets or what's going on in your life. This is going to stir up some deep emotions within you. So the full moon actually comes at the right time for you to release, Cancer. Okay. So, Cancer, that was your July 2021 reading. Once again, happy birthday. And, you know, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Check out my Instagram, TikTok, page. And also don't forget to check out Empath Butterflies Tarot, who does readings on the signs general and love. And also don't forget to check out Natter for Days, who interviews people during the pandemic. So Cancer, have a lovely July. You know, feel free to like write to me, or you know, send a comment to tell me how it's been for you. And also, you know, take care, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye.